Okay, so good morning everyone. I am Miss Princess T. Javier of La Sena de la Higa National High School, science teacher. So today I am going to share to you a food for thought, which I'm sure everyone should think about. Our food for thought this week is in connection with the celebration of the National Women's Month, and especially that tomorrow, March 8th, we will also celebrate the International Women's Day to recognize all working women in the world. Food for thought, women make change. So women make change. Yeah, we talk about women not because they are beautiful, pretty or talented, graceful and caring, but because women are dynamic leaders of change. So for many years in the past, the status of women in the society have been an issue all over the world because our society since then is dominated by men. Women were limited due to discriminatory laws and practices in the community. So some of which are as follows. Let me just mention a few. Age of marriage. Young women are forced to marry at an early age of 15 to 19, and sometimes lower than that. Also, the nationality or citizenship discrimination. This is commonly happening in other countries. To women who are married to a man of different nationality, when it comes to their children, the citizenship will be based on the father or the husband. Another is the obedience laws or the husband's marital power. Okay, example nito is in the country of Iran and Egypt. When a wife needs to travel, she needs to ask permission from the husband to obtain a passport and to travel. So they are not free to move to one place to another. In Sudan, a husband's control extends to requiring the wife to obtain the husband's permission before taking up employment in government. And then yung violence against women in the family. That includes beating and even rape within marriage. And it's very obvious that there are many, no, listed here. And others are not listed there. For example, in another in India, a woman was considered a man's possession. In the family, women had very little chance to say their opinion. There is no value. The men were the sole in charge of all decisions, and only men receive high education and they get the professional jobs. While the women, they stay at home doing the family responsibilities and house chores. So as you can see, there is gender inequality here. They receive different treatment. And the women, sad to say, unfortunately, they receive it's unrightful ang kanilang nare-receive. No, there is no human right. So as you can see, this gender inequality is a global issue. Women have fewer opportunities for economic participation. And then we have less access to basic and higher education, greater health and safety risk, and less political representation. And we do not want this to continue. We want this to stop. Another issue is the suffrage or the right to vote in political elections, which is applicable now because the upcoming election is coming. And here in the Philippines, we practice suffrage, no? We can vote whoever we want to be elected. So here is the map of America, the 50 states of America, and majority of women did not gain the right to vote in national elections. So only few states gave women full suffrage. So after years and years of being improperly treated, of course, we do not want this to continue. So, but of course, in the Philippines, we are one of the first Asian countries to allow this right. So we have here the former President Manuel Quezon. He signed the Women's Suffrage Bill on September 17 to legalize the women's suffrage in the Philippines. There you go. I support the women's suffrage movement. Mabuhay. Okay? As you can see, to change all this, we need women empowerment. We need to increase the spiritual, political, social, or economic strength of women. No? Because there is no gender equality in the society. Although efforts to ensure gender equality are underway in the present, such incidences are still happening around the world. So there is a need for women empowerment. And that involves developing confidence among women. So why do we need this? Because we have educational problem among women. We don't have access to higher academe for women, which we need to change the view of the society. Gender inequality, low confidence of women, there is no unity. Problem related with health, poverty and ignorance, because more of the women are in poverty, and then traditional barriers or customs. We need to change those. Also, we need to gain the same amount of power that men have. And just like Amor Powers, diba? She changed. Well, women are the backbone of the society and they play an important role in keeping the family together. Yeah. Educating women will mean that she will educate the whole family. And everywhere you look, women are leaders. And in the government, they are positioned in higher power. Okay? Empowered women can exert power to shape their families, communities, and countries. And then in history, this happened in New York in a factory wherein 140 working girls, mostly Italian and Jewish immigrants, died in the fire. Okay? And they are blaming the inhumane working condition and other labor practices, unfair labor practices. So it led up to the disaster. And this invoked the observance of the International Women's Day. So the Women's Trade Union League protested against the low wages, lack of protective legislation, and the very poor working conditions to which women workers were subjected during the time. So they started to speak up, and so not only in America, a movement also happened in Europe with Clara Zetkin and the Socialist Women's International. They demanded that March 8th should be the International Women's Day to celebrate working women around the world. And as they do that, they inspired the Russian Revolution, wherein 10,000 women demonstrated and joined the strike. Okay? So due to such history of women organizing around the world, that International Women's Day was officially recognized by the United Nations to celebrate women's contributions to all societies. So, nagkaroon na tayo ng United Nations entity for women, equality, and the empowerment of women. Kaya talagang women make change. Yeah? Okay, so itong result, until now, we celebrate the International Women's Day to celebrate all the contributions of women to all societies. Okay, so UN for Women are also asking us, no, this day, to take a closer look at some of the urgent issues women are facing during this time of pandemic. No, they want us to use our voice and platforms to spread the word. Why? Because number one, still there is violence against women and children, wherein they are trapped with their abuser at home, and they cannot access help support. Number two, gender pay gap. 70% of our women worldwide are at the front line, and yet they get paid 11% less than male. Okay? Three, digital gender divide. Not everyone can continue education, especially women, because 70% of women and girls don't have mobile devices and they are not literate when it comes to digital technology. Another, number four, informal work and instability. Women working in the informal sector have seen that their capacity to earn a living declines. So their earning is not enough. And then number five, period poverty and stigma. So in some parts of the world, women are seen to be dirty during their period. They are untouchable and a disgrace. So we should speak up for human right to manage periods safely and in dignity, and to promote sanitation at all times. In fact, underrepresentation as leaders in health. Yeah. So infections among female healthcare workers are up to 3 times higher than the males, no? But yet, women remain in the background of decision making. They are underrepresented in health sector leadership, and they are missing from the center of the COVID-19 response. And so this is something we need to face right now. So in this celebration of the Women's Month, we try to highlight the achievements of women and discuss the emerging women's empowerment, gender equality issues, and the concerns, challenges, and commitments. Yeah. So let us work together. Here is the 2022 National Women's Month celebration theme. We make change work for women. And this is for the whole month of March. Okay? So women's make change. When they are empowered, women's make change. And that could also mean that compassionate and harmonized actions and networks for gender equality. Yeah. So all of this, we have the legal mandates behind us, yeah, to support us. The Proclamation Number 224, Series of 1988. Yeah. And also the Proclamation Number 227, Series of 1988. Okay, and the Republic Act 6949, Series of 1990. Okay, all of these were signed by the former President Corazon Aquino in support of the National Women's Day and Women's Role in History Month and the International Peace Day for Women. Okay, so we do not want to replace men. No, we just want to to receive the same treatment and benefits and opportunities just like men. Okay? We want to promote equality among everybody. Okay? So, why? For what? Because who will benefit for this? The whole nation. It's not just women, but the whole nation. So, we want to emphasize the collective effort, collaboration, and participation just to ensure that women will not be left behind in the pursuit of change. Okay, so we are not alone in this fight, okay? Even famous women celebrities are empowering other women. So it's clear that we are not alone. So we have here Taylor Swift, and encouragement. She's encouraging everybody through her music. Yeah. Also, Emma Watson. Yeah. She's asking for equality. Okay. Also, the actress Nadine Lustre. She spoke of unity and togetherness among women. Miss Universe, Catriona Gray. Yeah. She speaks of the women's health and education among women. The singer Adele, and also voices out for equality. The Wonder Woman of the modern day, yeah. As she play Wonder Woman, she wants to tell the world that women are as powerful and strong like men. We do not need a male hero to save, no? Yeah. But women can do that too. All right. Also, Natalie Portman, who is so inspired by the stories of strong women of today. And Beyoncé, according to her, we need to reshape our own perception of how we view ourselves. We have to step up as women and take the lead. Okay? So talagang women empowerment. And from the British royal family, Miss Meghan Markle. Yeah, the women don't need to find a voice, according to her. They have a voice. They need to feel empowered to use it. And people need to be encouraged to listen. Demi Lovato, okay, according to her, women empowerment is using your voice to help the voiceless women be heard. Okay, so I hope you managed to reflect on what they said. Yeah. And of course, I hope that everybody are inspired and will be supporting, no, the whole month of celebration of the Women's Month. Let us promote women empowerment to make change happen, to eliminate gender gaps, and achieve equality. Yun na lang po at maraming salamat. Thank you.